Press Ctrl-Y to create a black background layer. Right-click, New, Shape Layer. Create an ellipse in the bottom half of your composition. Use the Pen tool to create a triangle. Duplicate the ellipse and move it to the side, make it smaller and change its color to something else. Create a position and scale key at frame 0 and 1 at frame 30 and move it up. Give it a bit of a curve, duplicate the layer and move it to the other side. And make sure to correct the curve to the correct side as well. Offset the second circle layer by 5 frames. Select both layers and duplicate them about 5 times and make sure to offset all the layers every 5 frames. Move the timeline slider until you find a frame where the ellipse pops up. Press B to trim your composition. Move your timeline until that right ellipse pops up again, and press N to make it a loop. Now select all ellipses and precompose them. Select your triangle and the circle and precompose them as well. Change the track mate mode of that layer to alpha mate inverted. Select both layers, precompose them, and call them fire. Now it's time for the effects. Drop a Gaussian blur effect, drop a levels effect, and change RGB to alpha, and move the sliders just like that. Drop a liquid effect, get this pyro brush, make it big, and deform your shape, something like this. Now drop a wave warp effect. Make sure to set the angle to a vertical position and set its speed to 0. And we're going to animate the face from 0 to 256, starting in the beginning of our loop to the end of our loop. Now, drop a roughened edges effect. At this point, feel free to play with all the values, but that's what mine looks like. To give it a bit more color, drop a gradient ramp and make it go from orange to red. Duplicate your frame layer, invert it, and make it smaller as well. Change the bottom color from the gradient ramp to yellow. And to wrap things up, precompose both flames and drop a dip glow, or if you don't have the plugin, a glow effect. And that's a quick and dirty way to create a fire animation in After Effects. If you like these short form tutorials, please give this video a like, subscribe if you want to see more in the future, and comment any questions you might have. It really helps the channel grow. Thank you. See you next time.